This is what is called a Lego pneumatic switch. In this position, the valve is off. Supply air is connected here. The switch on this side, air is connected to this hole. In this position, air is connected to this hole. There's a gentleman on YouTube that has a video where he shows how to take a number 11 X-Acto blade or a box cutter and keep cutting away on this until you can finally pry this apart. I've done that, and this thing is glued in the four corners and on the center post. With this type of plastic, you're going to have a good time trying to put that back together without messing up this valve. The way this is made, this is essentially two little O-rings, and in the center off position, they cover each of these holes. And when you flip the valve in one position, this elongated area will connect these two holes, or if it's going this way, connect these two holes. And I believe these can be safely and effectively drilled without disassembly. Each of these little nipples or stems, the initial opening on that is equivalent to a number 56 drill or 0.046 diameter. Goes down for about an eighth of an inch. And then down here, it's a number 60 opening or 0.040. And that's about 5/16 until it breaks through to the inside surface. I've marked these three drill bits 3/8 of an inch from the point with a black mark. And as I enter this with the drill, when I get to about 5/16, the point of the drill is breaking clear of this surface. I'm just using that 3/8 of an inch mark. I know before I get there, I should feel that bit breaking clear. I want to increase the size of these holes in three steps. The first bit will be a number 53, which is 0.059, followed by a number 50 bit, which is 0.070. A number 50 bit increases this opening 75% in diameter, or a little over threefold increase in cross-sectional area. A number 46 bit will more than double the diameter of the hole through here, and it will be a little over fourfold in cross-sectional area. This elongated section in here can easily handle the increase in cross-sectional area of the number 50 bit. It probably can handle most of the number 46 diameter increase. At least it won't be a restriction going through this area. I haven't played with Lego stuff very much, but what I have looked at has been made quite well. What appeared to be an O-ring type gasket that was in here is actually a fairly thick rubber seal, and it's made exactly the same on both sides. So if one side wore out, I guess you could flip it over and use the other side if they had made these pneumatic switches to where you could take them apart. More than likely they made it like this because you cannot assemble it incorrectly. Both sides are the same. This shows up quite dark on the video. A little closer shot here, you can see that these two ends are effectively an O-ring seal, and that elongated pocket I refer to as this section in here. When we start drilling this, we want to flip this to one side. We'll drill these two, and before we drill this one, we'll flip it over to this side. That will keep the drill bit entering this elongated cavity, which minimizes the chances of damaging that rubber seal. You can see that bit was clearing the plastic. The next bit is a number 50. Now I'll drill it to the final diameter, which is a number 46 or 0.081 inches. If you're going real slow with that, you can feel the drill bit as it breaks clear, testing the valve after drilling. It switches the air back and forth as it should. And all three of these positions seal in the off position. So that works quite well. Now this pneumatic switch, as it's called, has these little sections here that push over the Lego tabs. There's another switch that has these built into the back of it, I believe. I don't have one of those, but I can only assume that it's made in the same way. And you can take a small drill bit, stick it in there, engage where it's going. Using this video as a reference, I have now drilled out four of these successfully. I have not damaged the valve in the process. There really is no reason to increase these sizes when used with the Lego, because their system is using fairly high pressure air. I'm going to be using this on a system that's only 6 to 8 inches of water pressure, and to have any hope at all that this will work, I have to increase the size of these holes.